Good afternoon, everybody. So let us start our class. So as I told you that I already published your test 2 grade on Gradescope. You need to see your test 2 grades, all of your grades on Gradescope. Okay, not on D2L. Okay, maybe the labs are on D2L only. And then so let us go through first year experience on the schedule page. And we are here on this week, and by this week we have to complete a linked list. Okay, this is the top most topic in this course, the most top. Okay, so please, I will try my best to explain it as easy as I can, but this is really a top topic. You need to imply your object-oriented skill, and you need to apply your recursive method skill, okay, in order to understand this. Okay, but today's class is very important, this today and next day. These two classes are very important. These are the foundation for this week and stack QE, and also for maybe BST, all of this. So for the second half, this linked list is the foundation for the second half. So many universities, they do not include like linked list in this course. They actually, this is the linked list is an advanced topic for data structure. You will learn in depth more about linked list in data structure course, but we are giving you that startup. So it will be easier for you for your data structure course if you understand this. Yes.
Will the final replace
the final will replace your test if you did not appear for a test. But if you appeared and if you got zero, there is no replacement. Okay. Okay, so you know that one thing is that for all of your resources are first year experience resources page. All of the resources are, you see the first year experience resources page, you see slide repos, then you will see all of the slides here, okay? And even for your labs, you will get your lab assignment and lab instructions here on the first year experience page. These are public, okay, documents right now. Okay, so let me start. Linked. A linked list. Okay. So everybody ready?
Ready.
Yeah, everybody please close your cell phone. Close your phone and then close everything and give full attention. This is really tough. Okay. So if you do not give attention, then you will not understand this stuff, and then the next half of this course, you will not understand anything. Okay. And at any point, if you do not understand anything, please raise your hand and ask me, I will review. Okay, so our topic says linked list. Okay, and says linked, that means connected. Linked means interconnected, right? We understand linked means, in general, linked means interconnected, okay? And then we say list, and if that it has list in plural. I will tell you in a few minutes why it is in plural, okay? So list, what is a list? A list, like an array, okay? A set of content, some object or some element. In Python, an array is called a list. Okay, and in C Sharp and Java, you are familiar with array, right? Array is a list. An array is a list. Okay, there are other kinds of list. A list is more similar with a set. You know what is a set, right? Everybody knows what is a set. A set is a collection of some elements. It can be a set of friends, set of phones, set of phone numbers, set of numbers, set of grades, right? Set of tools, set of books, set of pens. Okay, but the main difference between a set and a list is that a set in general does not contain duplicate elements. You cannot have an element more than one time in a set. But in a list, you can have. You can have an element as many times as needed in a list. So now you understand the difference between a set and a list? Okay. There are, we know that in, so far you have learned about array. So array is an array, so far whatever you learned, that is called a static list or static array. Why do we call it is a static array? Because when you declare, remember that when you declare an array in either in C Sharp or Java or Python, you have to fix its size. What will be the maximum number of elements in your list? You have to fix that size, right? For instance, if you have set up your size as 10 of an array, but eventually you find that you have 11 elements, then you have no way to expand your array size while your program is running at the runtime. You don't have any a way to access array size while your program is running at runtime. So in that case, you may need to create another array with 11 or more as many needed with size. And then you have to copy all of the elements from your old array to the new array. That is time consuming and that is difficult, okay? So that is an issue, the limitation of static array. And reversely, think about that. For instance, you have declared an array with 1,000 or 10,000 or 1 million size. But eventually you found only 100 elements, or 10 elements. Then you can put all of your 10 elements in your array, but you will have some unused memory space. That while your program is running, you cannot use the assigned space for other purposes, for other programs. Okay, so that is a limitation. In order to resolve that limitation, so there is a concept of dynamic array. Okay, dynamic array or dynamic list. Some programming languages like C++, C++, C# and Java, and this modern programming languages, Kotlin, like these languages have dynamic array. There are several kinds of dynamic array, I would say. One of the dynamic array is called array list. For instance, in Java or C#, if you search for array list in Java or in C#, then you will see there are a lot of documentations and then a lot of programs. For instance, in here, I like you to go through with a simple anywhere. If you go to this site, one of this site, you will see that there are some documentations about array list. And array list is a dynamic array. It is built in with Java. In Java, and then I believe in C# there is a similar dynamic array. So in array list, if you go to the array list, you will see there are about 30 methods so far. So an array list is a class. This class is built in with java.util package. Okay. This class is built in with java.util package. And so in this package, you see there are some very commonly used methods like add, remove, like size of the list, and then remove all, is empty. There are some methods. Okay. So these methods can be easily used to do array list operation. So in this course does not include array list. Okay, so it is in general it is called collection. Array list, set. Okay. So this is your homework. Okay, I am giving you a study since this topic is not included in this course, but this is an important topic, you should know about it. So I like everybody to go do some Google search, okay, and go to some of these sites, this site, and you see this site. There are some very simple description, and also there are also programs. You see that for each of these methods, there are sample programs. So copy these programs and execute. Copy these programs already. So I already copied one of these programs, and then put in your this is your section, right? Go to your Eclipse, and then maybe copy a program and put in your Eclipse and run it. And try to understand this. These are very simple, not too complicated. At this point, you should learn yourself. Okay, so about array list. Array list is a very important topic you need to learn. Sorry. I'm not sure why my computer is getting too slow. Oh, okay. Maybe last night I copied some program from another section, array list. Let me copy from over here to there. Okay. Okay. So I just copied from another section. For you need to practice yourself. So you see the array list. This is a built-in class. Built-in type, right? A class is a data type, right? So this class is used to declare an array list variable or object, and then when you have array list, then you can array list dot add method. You can use other remove method or other methods. Yes.
Do you initialize an array list the same way in C sharp, or is it completely different?
Maybe next class I can see for C sharp. Today I will go a few more minutes. Okay, it's very simple. Okay, so for C-sharp people, first about array list in C-sharp. Okay, so you see that you will see this very simple. In order to create an array list and a dynamic array, for instance, you need array list to use array list data type. Okay, so then you say al my array list equal to new, okay, array list. Okay, new array list. Okay, so this is array list. So you see that, but where you will see that there is something here within angle bracket, right? Okay, we will learn that what is called. It is called generic. This is an optional part. Okay, generics means is giving restriction. For instance, this array list is declared with an intention that you will put only integer value in it, and then later you will, if you have some integer values, you can find maximum, minimum, average, mean, median, mode, right? For instance, but by mistake, if you enter, For instance, your intention was to input 10. But if you input 10 like this way, then this is not a 10, number 10, right? What it becomes? It becomes as a string, right? Although you meant to like this, you meant to make 10 like this. But by mistake, if you shoot like this way, then your program will not be executed because you cannot find average or mean of a string type, right? So that your program will give you an error. But in compile time, there is no error. In runtime, it will give you an error. So in order to resolve that possible issue, there is another way to restrict this array list, that it will take only integer value, for instance. Then you have to put within angle bracket, you have to put the wrapper class integer, integer. And it says that your type will be only integer. And say that it's a wrapper class, you put integer over here and also over here. And then, if as soon as you make this restricted with integer type, then it will not allow you to put any non-integer type. So then, as soon as I put wrapper this restriction, then it is giving me an error, right? This line, because this value is not integer value. So there is a less possibility to do mistake in entering data. Okay. So this is called, actually it is called generics. It is called, in programming language, it is called generics. Okay, people say generics, but I understand a way to say restricted. People say generics, then, but I understand in a way that it is actually restricted. I don't know how people, why people say it's generics. Yes.
Generic?
Yes. G-E-N. Generic. Okay. So your two tasks, okay, array list and generics. Okay. Please do some practice about. Okay. So this is your homework task. Okay. I have recommended to include array list and generics in this course. Maybe that will be implemented from next semester. But for you, I like to recommend you to learn yourself, okay? In your advanced course, you will need this. Without learning these topics, your learning of Java or C sharp will not be fulfilled. So, okay. So now we will go through about linked list. Okay, so then a linked list is a data structure, okay, that can grow and shrink as continuation at continuation time, execution time. Okay, so linked list is a dynamic array like array list. Okay, and in this course we will learn how to implement a linked list. Okay. So a linked list is a linear collection that is a sequence of nodes. Okay, so remember the word nodes. Okay, this node is the foundation or main component of linked list. Okay. There are different kinds of linked list. One can be is called singly linked list, and another called is doubly linked list. Okay. So this is why there are two kinds of linked list. This is why you said plural linked list. Yes. Okay. We need to understand about two kinds of linked list. One is singly linked list, another is called doubly linked list. Okay. This is why we use plural. Now understand why you use plural. And now I will tell you what is meant by linked. Okay, linked means, for instance, let me go to the next slide. So as I told you, the node is the main component of a linked list, and the structure of a node class is very simple. It contains two things. First one is it contains some data, and secondly it contains an address. So an address of what? The address contains the address of the next node, nothing else. Okay. So think about this way. For instance, if I have a list, so a node actually contains two things. This is a node. It contains, first one, it contains data. Data can be any type. It can be an integer type, it can be a string type, it can be boolean type, or it can be a custom or object type. Okay, and then the second one, it is called link. So link means the URL or the address of the next node. For instance, if I have a node 1, it's link 1, and then if I have another element, if I want to add another element to the next. For instance, let us think about it. I can add at the front or at the end. So if I add another in the end, so then, for instance, node 2, then this node will know who is next to it. Okay, then if I want to add another element here, 3 node, then this node will be connected with this previous node. Okay, so for instance, like if you live in a community, right? In a community, there are some row houses, for instance. And if you know only your neighbor next to you, on right side of you, okay? So then the right side of you, maybe this is your home, and next, this is your neighbor next to your right side, and this is the third neighbor. So for instance, if a new neighbor comes in your community, that maybe he will be like, for instance, 4. And if he takes place here, at the end, okay? So then if you want to know who is your new neighbor, so then this is your position, right? This is your position, so you will ask your next neighbor, okay? So please help me to understand who is the newcomer. So then he will ask his next neighbor, and he will get information from his next neighbor, and he will pass this information to him, and then he will pass it to him, and he will pass it to you, then ultimately you will learn. But there is no way that you can directly jump from here to there. And but for instance, so you understand this so far? So one node only knows only who is next to it, nothing else. Every node, it contains its own data and the information about next node. Where is the next node located? Okay? Yes.
What address does the last node have?
Okay, the last node, the address of the last node in general, it is null. So if we find there is nothing, address is empty, or null, that will be means that there is, this is the last one.
Who is the address of the first node?
And okay, we will go through this. When it's the implementation question, I'm giving a basic understanding. Okay, now for instance, if this node, like for instance, this node needs to be in place between, for instance, maybe 1 and 3, not next to 3. So then this previous this link needs to be broken. This previous link needs to be broken, and then it will be connected from with here, and then this will be connected with here, and then this is your node 4. Okay, so like it is chain, you see in the chain, like chain, one in chain, one is connected with next one is connected with next one. Okay, but in chain actually it is a doubly linked list. Doubly linked means every chain, for instance, the middle elements knows who is in front of it and who is next to it. Okay, if this node, if it knows that who is before it and who is next to it, then it is called doubly linked list. It knows both ways. So if you know who is your neighbor in your left side and who is your neighbor on your right side, and every community member, every household in your community, if knows that who is right to them and next to them, then this is called doubly linked list. And if they know only one way, only the right side or who are on the left side, not both sides, that is called singly linked list. Yes. Let me go through with the program, okay? So let me go through the program. I believe it will be easy for me to explain. So there are some slides. I will go through a live program. So there are some slides here. So if you go through this slide, for instance, this one is the connecting. Okay, so this one is the data 15, and then this is address. And the last one, you see that this cross means it is null. By the cross, it means this is null. Okay, so this slide actually there are few operations. So for a linked list, we are talking about singly linked list today. So like for instance, if you want to insert a new element, okay, so that insertion can be in front or end or in between. Similarly, if you want to delete something, deletion can be from the front element or the last element or any element from the middle. Like, so if there are some other operations, searching and then sorting. Okay, so these actually we will discuss insertion, deleting and searching. Okay, so if you understand insertion, then deletion is easier than, okay. And then if you understand insert and delete, and then search, maybe it will be easy to understand sorting. Okay, so you say this is the steps of insertion method. Okay, so this is depicted with a block, some blocks, and this is delete method block diagrams. Okay, so maybe there are some code snippets. This code are not a complete code. If you try to run this will not be running. Okay, because these are code snippets, not a complete code. Okay, so instead of going through each of these like code snippet, I like myself to explain this with a live program. That will be easy for me to explain, and I believe it will be easy for you to understand. Okay. So everybody please get ready, and within the next 20 minutes, okay, Let me take a break, 1 minute, 50 seconds. And then within next 20 minutes, give full attention. Okay, so then if you do attention, then I believe you will understand. But if you do not do attention, then you will not understand. These are really illegal stuff. Oh, please sign on that in the sheet, okay? Please pass that in the sheet to next. Okay. By the way, I have linked list. Okay. By the way, I have added a I already added a package. It's called linked list on your GitHub repository. You didn't know, I think you should know how to pull the latest code of a from a GitHub account. How many of you know how to get latest code from GitHub account? So it is called git pull commands. Okay. So it is called, it's one line. It's very single command. Like for instance, if I give git pull command here, for instance, I will do this way. Go to show local terminal, to terminal, or open terminal. Okay, this opening terminal this way, and then or open your what is that? Another way, open your command prompt and do cd workspace and go to cd your folder name. CSE, maybe this is your folder name. And execute execute here is execute git pull origin master command. Git pull origin master, execute this command, and then if you execute this command, if you see that your code is up, you see up to date, then that means you have latest code. And if you do not see up to date, it will face all of our programs, new codes, and your Eclipse should be updated automatically. And if this command does not work, then put dash F at the end. That means you are forced, enforce it, okay? Then it will be executed automatically. And then if you do not understand these, actually, maybe I have added a I have added a video on my GitHub on my YouTube channel. Where is that? On Git and GitHub related videos. So at the end of this video, so I have added a video of git pull command, okay, to face updated codes from a remote project. Okay, so watch this video, then you should know this, okay? Okay, let's start. Okay, so I have added a pull program. It is called linked list. Okay, next 15 minutes. Okay, everybody please give attention. Okay, I will not be able to finish it, but I will get a startup, and in next course I will. Okay, so as I mentioned that in the node class is the foundation, okay, of a linked list. So node contains two things, data and you see the node of another node. What is that one? It can be public, or it can be protected, or it can be default. Okay, in C sharp you see S in string, S is in S in lowercase, but Java it should be in uppercase. You see that it contains two things. A node contains two things, data and another node. And next, wait, okay. Another next. You see that this is here a recursive call here, right? You understand? When a method calls itself, then it's called recursive, right? So that a node is calling itself. This is recursion of what is getting here. So that's very simple. And this data, this two, a node contains two things, data and another node. Okay, so this is my node class. So this is my node class. It is very simple. You see, this is my, actually this is my node class. So actually what I want to do, I want to, this is a complete program. I want to delete this part for now, and then I want to copy and paste part by part as I explained. Then it will be easy. Otherwise, it's a lot of codes. It will be clumsy for you to understand. Okay. Okay, so what do I need? A node class. Class, node, right? Okay, then a node will contain, for instance, data. So, for data can be any type. Let me say integer, ID, this kind of data, and string, maybe name. Okay, so if we understand with two types, ID and integer and string, that we should be able to do any kind. Okay, so then what else? Another a node contains another node, right? Node, this is my next. For instance, this is the things that a node contains. Everyone understand this so far? Okay, so this is my node. This is simple, right? Everyone understand this? Do not focus on this later, okay? So let's focus here. So this is my node class. This is node is the foundation of a linked list. Okay, then let us make a constructor of this node in order to put enter data. Okay, so then how can I make it constructor? Public node. For instance, integer ID and then string name, and then this dot ID equal to ID and this dot name equal to name, right? So constructor will be simple. So everybody understand so far? ID equal to ID and this dot name equal to name. Everyone understand so far?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. This is my constructor. Okay, so then once I have my constructor, then I can create some node elements, right? For instance, node n1 equal to new node, I am putting an ID 1 and my node 1 equal to, for instance, n1. Name of my node, okay. So then I am so far I have this code until this is good, right? Everyone understand this? Simple, right? I'm creating object once I have node, okay. Then let us display, let us make a method display, like for instance, display node, like public maybe void display a node that will display a node. For instance, this out, actually I do have a code for this one, display node, like this line. So very simple. I am making my display node is very simple. I am to put ID equal to ID, name equal to name. So everyone understand this? Okay, so this display node method will display a node information. Okay, so far is good, right? I have only one error. So once I have my display node, then I can call this display node. Okay, so you see that this is in a Java file, there must be only one public class. So this is why I'm not making this public. Okay, and I have my public class actually this one, singly linked list. And then I have my main method within this singly linked list. Okay, so far is good, right? So far is good. Now, let me cut all of these codes until at the end. Not cut, let me comment it out until end. So if I run this program, can anyone expect what will be my output? Yes. For the node 1, ID is 1, right? And name equal to N1. For node 2, ID equal to 2 and name equal to N2. For node 6, ID equal to 6 and name equal to N6. Okay, but it will not do that. I am expecting that, but it will not do that because I have not done something. That's good? It should not be. Okay, actually, it should not be because I do not have my toString method overridden. Actually, I need to override my toString method. I don't know, in next class, I have a few minutes, so I don't like to go. So I need to do, in order to make sure that, I need to override the toString method. Okay, so far what you will do? Okay, that's good. It is showing me my ID equal to 1 and name equal to N1, right? For node 1. For the output of this. If I say node 1 dot display, okay, then it will show ID equal to 1 and name equal to N1. For this one, ID equal to 2, name equal to N2. For this one, ID equal to 5, name equal to N5, right? So everybody understand so far? Yes. Yeah, this is why I'm changing, because am I running the right code? Because I have another.
You're not calling the toString method when you're doing display mode, you're calling directly, you're directly asking for the object variable. Like you're asking the difference, the ID and name.
Let me see why it is. Okay. What is my output? Oh, actually, I don't have any output, right? I don't know. Maybe I have another same program in another project in section 3. Maybe it is getting code from there. But I did not expect that. What is my output? Okay, I need to go to my show view console. Oh, I don't have display method. I don't have output. Okay, so far is good, right? Everyone understand so far?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so be prepared. Okay, so I'm going to stop thing. Okay, so now, so these nodes does not know, this node are actually actually independent. These nodes do not know who are next to them. So then if I say n1.next, you see that every n1 there is another component is called next, right?
Another field next, right?
So then if I say n1.next, okay, then what will be, it will be printing. So you see that if I say this, if I say that n1.next, I want to print this one, so then what it will be printing? It says that n1.next equal to null, n2.next equal to null, n3.next equal to null. That means every node is independent. Every node does not know who is next to it. For instance, you are living in a society, in a community, you don't know who is next to you, to your home or apartment, okay? Nobody knows. So this is not an ideal society, right? An ideal society should, everybody, some people should know some of their neighbors, right? So that, what we need to do, we need to assign, we need to link each node with another node, right? So how do we, then we can do manually, like this way, if we want to assign this, for instance, we can do manually. For instance, if we do say n1.next equal to n2, that means the n1 will be first element and then n2 will be the next element. And then say n2.next equal to n3, n3.next equal to n4, n4.next equal to n5, and n5.next equal to n6, and n6.next equal to null. That means n6 is the end. Okay? So then, if I run this, if I write this, and then if I run this again, then it will be, after linking the nodes, it is showing me my expected output, right? It says me n1.next equal to n2, n2.next equal to n3, n3.next equal to n4, n4.next equal to n5. Okay, then n6.next equal to null, that means this is my last element. But this assigned linking is manual linking. Right? I have made this link manually. But this is complicated. If you think about that, if I have 1,000 or millions elements. So instead of linking this node manually, we need to come up with a way so that when we create a node, then automatically it will know who is previous to it. Okay, automatically it will know who is previous to it. Okay, that then the previous element will know who is next to it. Right? For instance, if I have my N1 node, okay, existing, and if N2 comes in this neighbor, then N2 will automatically know who is previous to it. Right? So then they will be linked together. If another node comes in this year, N3, then it will be linked with this one. So we need to find out a way so that this linking becomes automatic. Okay, in our next class, we will know how to do that. Okay, give me 2 more minutes, extra minutes, please. So in order to do that, you can write all of your codes. Those are like, for instance, insertion, deletion, all of this code. All of your code you can put in main method. You can put in this node class. Or you can create another method within my main class and do that. But in general, that is not done. In general, people, what they do, they create another new class as linked list, okay, and that class will contains all of the methods for your insertion, deletion, and then all of the stuff. Okay, and remember that it cannot can be some codes cannot be orphan. Orphan means you cannot put any code within a class. All codes, okay, must be bind in, within a method. A class contains only some fields, right? Some variables or fields and some methods, okay? So a class cannot contain some orphan code. Orphan code means, for instance, I cannot put any even print command. Can I put any print command here? No. So this is orphan code, okay? So this is a class, within a class. A class contains only some fields and some methods, right? Main method is a method, okay? So we cannot put any code like here. In your test, I saw some of you did some this kind of mistake. You put some codes within class directly. You cannot have that one. All codes must be binded within a method, okay? So this is the linked list. In our next class, we will expand this linked list class in order to put our code so that when we create an element, it binds, it links automatically with the previous element. We will put our insertion and deletion, all of this code, okay? So then, for instance, we will see that the linked list class, this linked list class is pretty large. And where is this end? It's pretty large. For instance, in my code, you will see that what I have shared with you, it contains all of this. All of this operation. Okay. So in our next class, we will discuss this. Okay. Thank you so much and have a good day.